Police was today called in to create order at the Ministry of Works and Transport offices after drivers stormed the premises to renew their permits. The impatient drivers queued up as they waited to access the facility. This has been attributed to the resumption of public transport and poor network at the facility. We have the report. As early as 6 a.m. today, scores of people had started flocking the Ministry of Transport and Works offices along the railway grounds in Kampala to renew their driving license. They lined up in long queues. After queuing for a long time with few people being attended to, they started to run out of patience. The police tried to calm them down, but in vain. They were bitter. The majority said yesterday they were not attended to due to the long lines.
First of all, they are telling us to line up here, and the fact that they are lining us here, they are not picking any of our staffs. They would have picked our receipts. Okay, they call names by name according to the receipts so that they can work on us, but there is nothing they are doing. We are standing here, we might end up leaving here at even 2.
Because at the end of the day, when it comes to one, the system will be down and we will have no work done. All we need is to work in a peaceful manner. But this is not, we are not handled at all. Traffic officers are very tough on the road.
First
I wish
of all,
we are given more time. All we need is more time and process the documents.
There is because nothing working as
we are through the payments.
They further claim that they were given an excuse of poor network, which has continued even today. These drivers have been prompted to renew their licenses due to the heightened operations by traffic officers along major roads. Others suggested that the government sets up branches across the country to issue driving licenses. Susan Kataike, the spokesperson for the Ministry of Works and Transport, agrees that poor network is responsible for the delays.
Yes, of course, we had challenges our first day of operation and with the UDLS. The numbers were too many, over 2,000 people. And of course, the system can only serve between 1,200 to 1,400 people. That notwithstanding, of course, the system also went off. The URA system was disturbing in the morning. Then after the URA system came back, then again the UDLS system went off. So yesterday was more of a system issue, which of course the rain didn't make things any better.
She, however, asked the public to stay calm, giving assurance that everyone will be served. She added that although they have the capacity to work on over 1,000 people per day, this time they were overwhelmed. Starting tomorrow, they will embark on a system of issuing numbers to those who come early. Story by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.
What we are requesting for is that people be patient with us. And also, tomorrow we intend to give people numbers. We intend to give to issue numbers, first come, first serve, so that they are in line with the numbers that UDLS can, that the system can serve.
She cautioned people to be cautious about their lives because the pushing and hustling from the queues puts their lives at risk of catching COVID-19.
People should also take personal responsibility and initiative. We all know that the pandemic is here with us, and we should take a personal interest to keep alive. Because you tell people to social distance, but they keep on pushing and shoving.
Story by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.